and no rules. And it's all made possible by Uncle Henry's, a book that we use to make our living. Buying, selling, swapping, trading, or as we say, down east dickering. On it. People are all the time saying print is dead, but Uncle Henry's is alive and kicking. Get the Bible while it's hot. Once we've got the good book in our hands, it's off to the races. Consulting the manual for leads on where to do some good old-fashioned knocking and talking. Knocking and talking is all about pounding on as many doors as we can to find as many deals as we can. Stuff we can turn around and list on Uncle Henry's for a sweet, sweet profit. Something different, we'll head out through into Hartford and Sumner and Canton. No, yep. Back way here.
Yep. Sounds like a plan, dude. What do you think?
This thing's overheating again already, Carl. Oh, yeah. He's already getting pinned again already. He's warm, Codwell.
Yeah.
Warren. Duct tape's gonna fix.
We're gonna have to call a tow truck for this one, I think.
No truck? That means no dickering, no deals, and no cash. And that's no good. Well, Codfish and me are stranded on the side of the road. Clint and his crew are ready to hit the ground running. Checking out Uncle Henry's to see what type of business they can stir up.
There's a 80 dirt bike for $450. You get that for $350, you can make $300 right now.
You guys want more motorcycles?
My daughter Nina's been wanting to learn more about the dickering business, seeing as how that's what me and Nate do for a living. So looking through Uncle Henry's today is a family affair.
So what do you think this is? Uncle Henry's Dickering Days.
Come and see the deal. Buy, swap, or trade.
You know who would love this? Is Bruce.
Oh, gosh.
Bruce loves going to auctions.
It's got everything that you need. People, food, there's stuff to buy.
So something like Dickering Days sounds like it's right up his alley.
What are we buying?
A table. Oh, they're talking about the Dickering Days thing. That just sounds like a stupid flea market. I think it might be right up the line with your auction.
So what happens at Dickering Days? What are we getting ourselves into here?
Dickering. You have no idea. There could be 40 people. There could be
thousands.
Thousands of people.
Thousands.
Wait.
Oh, we're going. Being at Dickering Days is probably like hanging out with a whole bunch of people just like Dad, because who else is going to be going to that?
I'm kind of apprehensive to go, but I mean, if there's a bunch of people, there should be people that... Hi, John.
I think we might as well give it a try. We're not doing anything else next weekend.
You want to go look at your stuff?
Yeah, let's go see what we can sort through it.
Here's the thing about Uncle Henry's. If you're looking at an ad, it's almost guaranteed there's another dicker looking at it, too. And they probably have the same idea as you.
Uncle Henry's Dickering Days. What's that about? It must be like the big garage sale or something.
It says right here.
What are they, putting the book in one place?
Hundreds of spots for tabletop items as well as larger items, such as cars, ATVs, boats, snowmobiles. That's perfect.
Let's do that. Dickering Days sounds like exactly what we need to generate some cash right now. We are just going to have to figure out exactly what we want to take down there to sell.
So this place is going to be a perfect opportunity to sell some stuff we already have.
The thing about Dickering Days is it's a swap and trade festival. It's one-stop shopping. We can make some decent cash without having to travel too much, and that's an opportunity that we can't miss.
I'll bet we'd sell half the stuff we pick up there at that event.
It looks like the entire state of Maine is looking for things to sell at Dickering Days. And old Clint, he's already on the job.
Farm and garden.
I found that in Oak Henry's for an old lawnmower. It's right here in Sangerville. So I'm going to swing by and take a look.
Hey, you must be Dick.
Yeah.
You must be Clint.
Yeah.
When's the last time you mowed the lawn?
Oh, 2 seconds. It's been a while. I don't think I've ever used it, to be honest with you.
That lawnmower looks like it belongs in a museum. But around here, these old lawnmowers are popular because people use them for decorative lawn art. So if I can get this and take it to Dickering Days, it might draw traffic to our table. I'm saying late 50s?
Oh, yeah. She's an old-timer.
Do you mind if I pull it over?
No, go ahead. See if it'll run.
I would want to see if it's got compression. I seriously doubt it would start. I bet every dollar I made that this thing is not going to crank up. But I want him to see that so he doesn't think it's worth more than it is.
I don't
feel any compression at all.
What's your price range on this? A dollar? $2?
Well, I'd have to have more than that. Probably $75 or so.
I'm just as likely to pay $75 for this thing as I am to fly to the moon. I need to get that notion out of his head right now. I mean, it's no fries. It's just an old lawnmower with no compression. You know what I mean? It's
you're
not.
You're right.
They made a million of them.
25.
I'll tell you what. I will get this thing somewhere where somebody's going to want it. You can keep it if you want to. I don't care. But it's only worth $10 to me.
The only thing I'd use it for, and I guess probably, is a boat anchor. I don't know. I have no idea.
I'll give you $10 for this boat anchor right now.
$10.
Thanks, Dick.
Okay.
I had a feeling these negotiations wouldn't drag off too long. I don't see a line of cars out on the street waiting to buy this prehistoric lawnmower.
Let's see if we can help you get that.
All right, I'll drag it over. Clint's starting to load up for Dickering Days. And a few miles away, the Morin brothers got the same notion.
Let's head out there and see what we can make happen on these sleds.
We saw an ad at Uncle Henry's with two sleds under for sale. Sleds are sporty and eye-catching. They're the type of items that are likely to attract customers to our table at Dickering Days. The ad says that the guy wants $3,000 for the pair. We're going to need them cheaper than that if we're going to turn a profit at Dickering Days.
What's the mileage?
920 miles.
And that's the original miles?
Yeah.
Huh. Yeah.
Like I said, I don't have much time.
I guess not. Get up there and fire that thing up.
I'll do it.
Oh, Phil, I would never talk to you that way. I'll talk to Greg that way, but... Honestly, this is a sharp-looking sled. Part of our business is working on snowmobiles, so we know snowmobiles, and this one's super cool. It's a 2000 Ski-Doo MXZ700. It'll do over 100 miles an hour, and it's only got 900 miles on it. This thing is definitely badass, but it would not be a good dickering strategy to tell this guy that.
Check that other side. Let's check out the other one you have.
This one here, the 99, four-wheel deluxe, 670. New starter, new battery.
No, that's a lot of smoke. Maybe not that one. Nobody's going to buy anything that smokes like that, and we're not going to have time to fix it before Dickering Days. So I'm interested in the black one. What would you take for just the black one?
$1,200.
I was thinking probably more like $600.
Nah, you definitely can't do that. The lowest I could do would be $1,100.
If it was pre-season, ready to go, I think realistically I'd probably be, at the most, $800.
$800?
Yeah.
Just got done putting a bunch of money into it.
Last season, though.
Right.
Yeah, and you rode it.
Right.
So you did get some use out of it. I think 800's a fair price. You want to do 800?
Yeah, I can do 800.
Want to do 800? All right, cool. All right, let's go load that thing up. That's $800 we've sunk into Dickering Day's inventory already. And that's a lot to have to come straight out of our pockets. Means we really need to flip this sled for some serious cash.
All right.
There you go. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Well, the whole world's out dickering. Everybody's buying, selling, swapping, trading. Except for Codfish, Duke, and me. All we're doing is stewing.
He's coming out of here in good shape. I can't tell where it's coming from.
This day's gotten off to a wicked bad start. My old truck is broken down, and it don't look like she's going to move again without some serious repair work.
That's going to cost us money. We ain't even got started.
I know.
We ain't got gas in the tank yet. Well, what do you think?
Now we're going to have to call for a tow.
Call the boys. Call the twins.
We're going to need a tow and a repair. So I think our best bet's to call the Savage twins. They're a couple of boys that we've done business with in the past. 600 guys in Chelsea.
Yeah, sounds good. Thank you.
All right, thank you. And their garage is just up the road. So I think we can make a deal with them.
Hello?
Hey, this is Bennett and Codfish. Hey, we're out in Milton Plantation. We're broke down side the road out here. I was wondering if we could get you to stop and grab Caldwell's truck so we got something to get out of here. Bring that to us and grab this thing and bring it back.
I'm pretty busy right now, but I think that could last. We're right out here.
Well, listen, this is the other end of it. We ain't got two nickels to rub together. I know you've been after that suicide door on that parts truck I got up back. Bring his truck over right now, tow this back to the shop, and sharpen your pencil on a head job. You can have that door. The Savage twins, they're looking for a suicide door for one of their trucks, for one, a parts door, and we just happen to have one on our parts truck back at the garage. And this door, plain Jane's, about $200. He's getting a $200 door for a $100 tow. We ain't even made our first knock and talk this morning, and it's costing us money.
Breaking a sweat, and we ain't even done no work yet.
Codfish and me, we just broke down on the side of the road, so we've called in for a tow. But the boys we called in to rescue us, looks like they're taking their own sweet time. And we need to make some cash, so there's no time to waste.
Where is he, Codwell?
I hope he hurries up.
It's getting hot out here.
It's getting warm.
No shade.
You hot boy, huh?
You get a little shade.
I know I can't take this heat much more.
The longer this takes, the longer Codfish and me are out of the dickering business. We're losing cash by the second. Not to mention, I'm worried about my truck. This old girl, she's been good to me, and I hate to see anything bad happen to her.
I hear something coming. Oh, yeah, here he comes. Nice.
Yeah.
Good deal.
Awesome.
We're out of here. Sweet. Drive it up in front of him.
That's good.
Well, old boy, appreciate you getting out here and squeezing us in this morning.
Yeah.
I'm pretty positive it's ahead.
Yeah.
We've been having trouble with it for a while, and then what it did this morning. And like I said, we could have limped it home, but I'd have probably ruined the whole block. So
yeah, definitely.
What would you do me on a heads job?
Usually it's about 900, because we got to send the heads out, and by the time we get the parts
I'd
everything.
Spend about six.
Yeah, I don't think we could do it for 600. We'd have more into it than that.
I still got that parts truck. You could pick and power off in there. There's still some good pieces on there.
The brothers, they love my old parts truck. So I plan to use it like an ATM.
Doors are still good on it.
Yeah.
The hood's still good. The fenders are good. The bump is good.
Yeah,
what's the best you treat me? Now let you come pick on the truck some more.
Probably 800.
800, plus that's another 100 off.
Yeah, plus a lot of sticker.
Plus you want to pick on the truck a little more.
Yeah.
You get up here this week, pull a couple more parts off it. I'll give you $750, we'll get it done.
Okay, yeah, that works for me. Thank you.
All right, we'll see you this week.
Yeah,
thank you, boy.
Yeah.
Letting the brothers pick at my parts truck, that took a good chunk off my bill. That 900 smackers it would have cost me for the tow and repair, that's been chiseled down to 750. Of course, I don't want to pay $750 out of pocket for anything, but we'll get to that. Right now, Codfish's truck, we got to get that back to Mrs. Fish. Since car rentals are for flatlanders, we're going to have to dicker for a new pickup truck. And it's going to take some dickering to get us into a new set of wheels. Yeah, we got to pull off something now, Caldwell. While Codfish and me are saying so long to our old four-wheel friend for now, Clint's ready to say sayonara to two wheels of his own.
I can't believe you're getting rid of this thing.
I just don't need it. I got all the bikes. This is the one I don't ride. I'm sending it. I really don't want to do this Dickering Days thing, but seeing how Nina is sucking me into it, I'll just take the opportunity to clean up, get rid of some stuff, and make a few bucks while I'm at it.
Will you take this? Why not? Check out this headlight. He's got all kinds of motorcycle parts up here.
Look at this. It's so pretty.
I know what I could take, or we could take. Recognize these?
I do.
My dad got us these double-barrel shotguns in a trade years ago. We haven't used them in ages, and they're just sitting around collecting dust. Around these parts, guns are big sellers. And it's legal for a private seller to sell guns without any paperwork. So these will definitely move at Dickering Days.
Somebody will want them.
Somebody will.
That's cool. Yeah, let's load it up and see what else we can find, I guess.
All right, sounds good.
While Nate and Nina are plundering their belongings for Dickering Days, the Morin brothers, they're about to plunder someone else's.
Dude, check it out.
Trail cat.
This is right up our alley. We found an ad in Uncle Henry's for a moving sale, and we're hoping to find some items to move at Dickering Days. Okay, head up this side. We'll do it one side at a time. Already, we're accumulating some things that we want to take with us. We've got a chainsaw, a machete, and a circular saw.
How are you guys doing today?
Hey, good. How are you?
Not too bad.
Yeah. So, how much can I buy that little bundle for?
You're looking at $225 worth of stuff.
$125 for the pile. And we're going to buy more stuff on our way out.
How much more?
Here's $200. I put money right in this guy's hands so that he'd feel comfortable and let his guard down. It's hard to resist cash in hand. I think once we start negotiating prices, he's going to feel a lot better, and I'll be able to buy the things I want for the prices I want.
On that one.
So let's work off my credit of $75.
All right, you keep
shopping. What's your bottom dollar on those skags for the snowmobile?
For you, $25.
How much you want for the toolbox underneath with the drywall tools?
Give me another $25, and you can have that whole box.
That I will take, but I'm going to hold at $20.
Okay.
So I got $30 more to spend.
All right.
We have $30 left to spend, so we're going to look at these lawn chairs.
These are nice Daytona Beach chairs right here.
Yeah, Jay, try this with Warren Nate. Oh, dude.
Oh.
Dude.
All right, you own the chairs.
Hold now.
These are nice Daytona Beach chairs right here.
The Morin brothers are at a moving sale, considering whether or not to buy some lawn chairs to turn over at Dickering Days.
Yeah, Jay, try this one.
And right now, it looks like they bought at least one.
Dude! We always play pranks on each other. Jason probably should have never sat in that chair.
Oh, I
because he knew he was going to get it.
Dude, I think you're going to have to buy this one now.
Jeez. The lawn chairs are actually a good deal, so we're going to use the rest of our cash to buy the whole set. But there's one item I've really got my eyes on. So I've given you $200. I would love for you to just throw that and go cut in. I think that's a good deal.
Man, I don't know.
Dude! This is textbook Greg. A late model, high-end go-kart could bring $1,000. This one probably won't even bring $30, but Greg just has to have it.
That's pretty tough business.
$200. Look at all the stuff you got rid of.
You guys own a pawn shop
or
something?
You're moving. I can own a pawn shop.
Holy catfish.
$200. Done.
Get out of here.
All right.
Load it yourself, because I'm not helping.
I'll load it up. With the $200 we just spent, we're now $1,000 into Dickering Days. That's a lot of money. So we're banking on being able to sell these items for a nice profit. If that doesn't happen, we're going to have to eat this cost, and that is not going to go down easy.
What a piece of crap. Look at that.
It's going to be fine.
Dude, I'm so hanging that chair up in the garage.
That is a memento.
This.
I remember what it was like to be able to load up your truck. But unfortunately, right now, I don't have a truck of my own, since mine is in the shop.
Let's swing into Berlin City and see Chad.
Codfish's wife needs the truck, so we ain't gonna be able to use it all week long. So we're gonna go to our favorite used truck lot to do some wheeling and dealing, and hopefully get a sweet deal on some wheels.
I do. Well, for warm today, buddy. Come on.
Hey, how you doing, Chad?
Hey.
How you
doing, old boy?
Hey, what's going on?
How you been, buddy?
Been a while. How you doing?
Chad's definitely a good dicker. You know, that's his business. That's his job. He's a salesman. He's a clever boy. We're broke down right now.
Oh, you broke
coming
down?
Through the neighborhood. Yeah, we're in Codfish's truck today. We're broke down. Mine's getting fixed.
Is it? When I saw Tony today, I knew right where he wanted to go, right out to the back where his heart is. I do have a truck there. I got a red Silverado right there.
Yeah.
That one's a couple grand.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
I also got a couple.
Let's keep looking. That's
yeah. Oh, yeah, it's a little too much.
Yeah, right now it is. Right now it is.
This baby, I'll tell you what, she's got a little bit of flaking on the bottom. Good, solid vehicle, though.
Bumper's getting a little tweaked on
it. Yeah, a little bit of surface rush there.
That's nice. Yeah.
What's Duke think of it? Come on, Duke.
Yeah, boy, get up in there and try it out. Load up.
Oh, Duke's all, he's got his spot ready. Gotta love it.
What's the bad news on this one?
Here's how you find out how Stanley earns his keep and that nickname. Because much like the deadly Atlantic codfish, he should never be underestimated.
Bad news is I need $850 out of it.
$850.
$850, yep.
I was thinking more like $3.
More like $3, yeah, geez, I can't do that.
We're beating you up too much.
I know, geez, it's awful early in the morning here, come on.
You ain't got no maintenance you need done around here, no projects.
Nope, you got a couple junks I could have hauled off, though.
You got a couple of these you need out of here?
Yep.
You sweeten the deal on that a little, if we clean the ad up a little, if we can move a couple of these?
How about we do $500?
How about knock another $100 off that and we'll do it? $400.
How's $450 sound?
You think we can do that? It'll get us something to beat around in for a day or two.
Yeah.
All right, you got us this time. Yeah, treat us better next time.
That's it, $450?
Let's do it. $450.
Good deal, thanks.
Thank you, Chad.
Thank you. No
let's
problem.
Get out of the hot
yeah,
seat,
let's
buddy.
Go get the title and get her done.
Yep. Laying out good money for this truck, that's like watching my wallet bleed to death. The good news is, by dealing my junk car for parts, we're going to end up with a blue SUV for free. But the bad news is, I'm still $750 in the hole for the repair job. Duke, what do you think? Was that a good deal or what? And this old truck and me, we go back a long ways. And I love the old girl, and I ain't gonna lose her without a fight. Right now, I'm wishing I'd have been able to prepare for Dickering Days. Because this looks like a big swapping and trading free-for-all.
We'll stop.
Yeah, go ahead.
Think you could do 20 on that stack?
All this stuff yours?
The junk is mine.
I see that. I got plenty of that.
I've never been to Dickering Days, but I've read Uncle Henry's plenty of times. And what I do know about people that like Uncle Henry's, they like junk. All right, sounds good.
Sounds good.
I appreciate
Thank
that.
Thank you very much.
I'm here to network. I'm here to win friends and influence people.
How's it going?
This isn't just about today. This is about 6 months from now, a year from now.
A good connection always comes in handy down the road. Best for today, a dicker that knows what he's up to, he's going to make some cash.
Interested in the go-kart?
Yeah.
I'd really like to make some cash on this go-kart that we picked up earlier. It didn't cost a dime. Anything we make is going to be clear profit, and I'm guessing we can get $40 for it.
What do you want for it?
$75.
$75, you go less.
I'd probably entertain a reasonable offer.
All right. I'll give you $35 for it.
$35?
Yeah.
I don't think I can go that low. I think I'd do $60.
$60.
This guy looks interested, and I think it's a gift, so I'm pretty sure he's going to pay a reasonable price.
$45,
huh? You got a kid you're going to use that thing for?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's going to be a project?
Oh, yeah.
I'll let it go for that. All right. Cool. Well, we paid $1,000 for items to bring here, and we've made $45. We're in the hole $955, and we've got to climb out of that hole pretty pronto.
The good news is Greg might have made himself a new friend.
How you doing?
Good. Bruce Thomas.
I'm Tim Morin.
Tim. Glad
my brother Greg. My friend Jason.
Jason.
Yeah.
Glad to meet you.
You guys all set up?
Yeah, we're all set up. Looks
perfect.
Like you guys are pretty well set.
Perfect. I've heard of Bruce. Bruce actually seems like a pretty easygoing guy. Friendly. Kind of guy you want to be buddies with. But you know what the Morins like to do to their buddies. Dude!
The toilet, I'm kind of curious about that.
Are you interested?
No.
Oh, I'm gonna sell that.
I've heard of the Morin brothers, and they have a reputation for playing pranks.
If I'd have known that there was a market for that, I would have brought.
Right. Listen.
What they don't know is that they've met their match.
Jeez. Do you know if there's more Maine-type things or more cabins?
All the Dickerers in the state of Maine are gathering up at Dickering Days, hoping to pull in some serious cash. Dickering Days is swap trade, wheel deal, hus trade, barter. Clint and his crew are there, and of course, so are the Morin brothers. They've got their Dickering hats on right now, so it's every Dickerer for himself.
How you doing?
Good. There are all kinds of things here for you.
You do? I see that.
Make me an offer.
How much do you want for this? Block and tackle is a rig you use to pick up heavy things like an engine or a tire or something like that. And everybody around here needs one. And if not, then I can just keep it for myself. For a couple bucks.
How about six?
I can't do six. How about $2?
I can't do two.
How about $3?
How about four?
$3. That's where I'm at.
Okay, you just got it.
$3? All right,
yep,
cool.
Yep.
Thank you
very much. Enjoy.
I will, thanks.
That block and tackle, that ain't something you just find at the local hardware store. And neither is that ancient lawnmower old Clint's hoping to sell just outside.
I gotta carry all this stuff home. You wanna buy something?
I'm thinking about it. What year is this?
You know, there's some tags on it. It's a weird seven-digit number. It does say Lawn Boy on it somewhere.
Flathead.
It's a two-stroke. Two-stroke engine is more compact, it's lighter, it's more efficient than other kinds of engines. And that's great in a functional lawnmower, which this one isn't. You want it for a display or do you want a mow?
No, I want it for like a toy.
Yeah?
You know, a display.
That's a relief, because I'm pretty sure this engine hasn't cranked since the Eisenhower administration. I'd love to not load this thing on my truck if you'd like to buy it.
I can give you $20 for it.
Give me 25? 25 sounds like a deal to me, man.
Okay, yeah.
I bought this lawnmower for $10 and I sold it for 25. That's a whopping $15 profit. It might buy me lunch. I definitely need to sell something worth some money if I'm going to make any money here at Dickering Days. I don't have to load it. That may be jazz. You need help bagging it over? You got it.
It looks like Clint made himself at least a little cash. But across town, Codfish and me, we're worried about having to lay out even more bucks for the repair of our truck.
Stop, check on the truck?
Yeah, we might as well pull in and see how they made out. With my truck broke down, I had to go out and buy an old beater. Right now, me, Codfish, and Duke are running over to the Savage Brothers in our new truck to see what's going on with the old truck. And hopefully the brothers won't savage us too much on the price. Come on, Duke. Come on, old boy. What are you up to, old boy?
Nice looking rig.
It is for 19 years old. It's a nice old rig.
You want to go take a look?
Yeah, let's take a look.
I'm pretty certain this head right here is cracked. It was all milky.
Always something, ain't it?
Oh yeah.
So what are we looking at here now? What do you think we're looking at?
A new head usually is around $300, all ready to go. That's on top of what I tell you before.
Ah, boy, that's terrible, terrible, terrible. Well, the $750 the Savages quoted us earlier was just to fix the motor. But just like always, the mechanic found more problems that need attention to. This job just got a whole lot more expensive. But I love this truck, and I'll do whatever it takes to keep her alive.
What's that rig you're driving out there?
That's a 95 Tahoe. That's very clean.
What do you think you're doing with that?
I just picked it up.
Yeah. What's it have the miles on it?
It's got about 160,000.
Is that something you part with it?
I probably would.
You would?
I'd probably get rid of it. Everything's for sale. Hey, this job just got a whole lot cheaper.
Can we go take a look at it and see what it's all about?
Let's go kick the tires and look it over.
Yeah, go look at it.
The Savage Brothers have never seen a truck they could resist, or at least peeking under the hood of it. And this Chevy's no different. And once they start sniffing around, I'm pretty sure I can get them to bite. But look at this.
Yeah.
That's what sold me on it when I just looked at it, guys, as I reached through the window and touched the key, and it just, no top end knock, no hesitation.
Yeah, it sounds real good. Yeah, it needs a little work.
Oh, yeah, you know. Right now, I'm hoping the Savage Brothers are going to like the looks of what we got here, and they'll trade a truck for a truck repair.
How about we'll do that, Si? We'll get your engine running good, do the head job. We'll call it a deal for this.
All right. One last thing, I guess.
What's that?
We'll need a cold beer and a ride home.
Sure.
That work?
Yeah, it works for me.
Let's do it.
Yeah,
let's do it, guys.
All right.
So this truck repair, it was going to cost me a pretty penny. But the Savage Boys, they took my used truck instead, and that truck didn't cost me a dime. So I did what I set out to do. I got my truck repaired for free. Considering all the crap we had to deal with, the dickering, it come out pretty good. Want me to pull this over to the side?
Yeah. Yep.
Well, that was a pretty sweet dicker. And over at Dickering Days, the Morin Brothers, they're after some sweet dickers of their own.
How you doing?
Good.
This your sled?
That is. I'm Greg.
Daryl.
How you doing?
$2,500.
$2,500.
Man, this guy is the only one who's shown any interest in this sled. If he doesn't buy it, we're going to be out $800 at the end of the day.
Realistically speaking, the sled has 900 miles on it. It's in phenomenal shape.
He is not going to make an offer. And now I think we just ate 800 clams, and they did not taste good.
It's worth every dime of the $2,500 we're asking.
This
your sled?
That is. $2,500.
$2,500.
We spent $800 for this sled, and we really need to sell it here at Dickering Days and turn a profit. We've only got one guy that's even seemed half interested in it. I don't know if he's going to make an offer, but we really got to sell it. We might be out $800, and that's really going to hurt. Listen. So, that's your $2,500. Brand new, this sled would go for around $8,000. Even though it's used, it's in really good shape. So at $2,500, this guy's getting a solid deal.
What makes it a $2,500 sled?
Well, actually, the condition and the year make it a $2,500 sled. I wouldn't sell it to you saying that it doesn't need anything, because you should run it through the shop. You know, we highly recommend full tune-up on something like this, just because we don't know the history of it, you know? We've got a full snowmobile shop, so...
I'd give you my mechanic work and $2,000 for it.
So how about $2,400, and then you hire us to do the service on it? He is not going for it. I am definitely going to have to sweeten the pot. So why don't we do this? You're going to hire us to do the service on this, and $2,300.
Oh, yeah, I knew that.
Want to do that?
Yeah.
Well, this is awesome. We're in the hole 955 smackers. With this sell, we're 1345 in the black. All right, so that'll work for you?
That sure will.
Good, thanks a lot.
Well, looks like the Morin Brothers had a pretty successful dicker. Back inside, Bruce is showing a little interest in that block and tackle that Greg picked up earlier for $3. And old Greg, he sees the opportunity to get one over on a fellow dickerer. Because every dollar counts when you're dickering.
What'd you get for it?
What would you have paid for this?
I would have paid...
There's no tag.
$5.
You would have paid $5.
I would have paid $5.
You give me $5
for it? I would. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, no question.
Perfect.
So I'm going to go sell it.
All right. All right, go get it out there.
Take care.
Bruce has no idea he paid me $2 more for this item than I paid for it. It's fun to actually out-dicker the guy who's supposed to be the master of dickering.
Greg is feeling mighty confident. And outside at Clint's table, the next generation of dickerers, they're starting to feel confident, too.
Hey, how are you?
Pretty good. You know, how much is that shotgun right there?
This one right here?
Yep.
We got that gun in a trade, and it didn't cost us anything. But I think I could get at least $100 for it. That'll make my dad proud. I'm looking at 150.
150? Damn. It's kind of steep. What do you do? About $75?
How does 125 sit.
How about 90 bucks?
I don't know. This is a good one. We've used it. We used it last year. It shoots straight. It's a good gun. We have one just like it. So the lowest I'm going to go is 100.
All right.
Can you do that?
Yeah, I can do that.
All right. Well, there you go, sir. Well, thank you very much. You have a nice day. So we were only up like 15 bucks. And with the sale of this gun, which we already had and didn't cost us anything, we're like 115 bucks in the black. But it's still not anything to really brag about. We need to make some serious cash, or my dad's gonna ground me for dragging them here. Boom! That's how that's done.
Well, the old dickering apple, she don't fall far from the tree. Meanwhile, another dickering elder is about to see an opportunity to prank a fellow prankster.
Oh, this is the setup, huh?
This is it.
Wow. Hey, how much for this block and tackle?
You don't want that.
Well, I don't know. I'm thinking about it.
This could be too much fun. If I could buy it from one brother and sell it to the other, that would be sweet. $10.
No way.
Yes.
$5.
No, that's a nice piece. No
five
way.
Bucks.
No way. $9.
I'll give you $7.
$8.
$7.
I'll do it.
You got it.
How about we just make it $8?
No, hell no.
Fine, we'll make it $7.
$7.
Good man.
That's awesome.
I'd love to be a fly on the wall when he shows his brother that block and tackle that I bought off of him for $5. Is the same one I just sold them for $7. I'll teach those guys some down east humility.
So.
All right, well, thank you.
Awesome, thank
that
you.
Was good.
Looks like Bruce is dreaming of serving up some humble pie to the Morins. Meanwhile, it's been days since I seen my baby. I sure miss the old girl. She's been under the weather at the truck hospital, but she's all better now. And today, she's gonna get sprung. Ah, she's looking good. The hood's still up, though. Hey, old boy. Good morning. How you doing?
Good.
Looks together.
Back together, right?
Yeah, I got it all back together.
How's she running?
Good. It's running good.
Nice. All right. We'll go try it out.
Okay.
We have the bad news. We'll be back shortly.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, boss. You need your wheels to do your deals. But in Maine, the rubber doesn't just meet the road. Sometimes it fries the road. Good to have the old girl back, Andrew. And that's how we roll, down east style. Well, I'm celebrating my mobility. Tim, he's celebrating that block and tackle he just picked up from Bruce. And he can't wait to show his brother Greg.
Dude, look what I found. Just what you were looking for.
Are you kidding me?
No.
Did you buy that off Bruce's table?
Yeah, why?
I sold it to Bruce.
Are you kidding me? You're kidding me, right?
I bought it for $3. He offered me $5. I took it.
I just paid $7 for that thing. You give me $5?
I would.
Bruce, he just pranked the Morin brothers. He bought a block and tackle off one of them, turned around, sold it to the other for a profit. Yeah, the day ain't quite over yet. And the Morin brothers, they got a plan to get even.
Hey, how are
you? How's it going, guys?
Hey, what's going on?
Not much, how are you?
I'm Tim.
Hey, Nate.
I'm Greg.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Trying to find some cool stuff?
Yeah.
This is where it's at, right here?
Trying to get rid of some stuff, too, actually.
I'll bet you are.
Yeah.
We all. We know that Nate works with Bruce, so if we can sell this to Nate, it's the same as Bruce selling it to one of us. We're going to play him like a fiddle.
That's pretty wild.
Yeah,
that's
you're cool, from farm country, aren't you?
I am.
You must be able to use one of those.
Yeah, I've used one a couple times.
Hang a deer or something?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Right, exactly.
How much do you want for this?
Poor fish. He doesn't even know that he's on the hook. Now we can just reel him in. $15.
What about 10?
No, I
10?
Can't.
10? Oh, come
no,
on.
$12.
$12. You know what? I'd give you $12, but I don't have $12. What about 10?
Just take this.
I guess you gotta take $10.
Take that.
$10.
I'll do $10.
No, I feel like I stole it now because you guys.
Well, that's all right. Cool.
All right.
Awesome.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate
stop
it.
Over, see if you want.
All right.
You know, Bruce, you may be good at dickering, but when it comes to pranking, the Morins are the masters.
Dude, twin dickering.
The Morin brothers, they're ready to do a victory lap. And a stone's throw away, old Clint, he's in need of a victory, too. If he plans on leaving Dickering Days with anything more than petty cash.
Cool bike there.
Look like $1,500?
I don't think so. Give me 900 cash right now.
That's a fair offer for what I get in it. But I know what these things go for. You know what I mean? I just know what they go for. So you got to be a little closer than that. I'm willing to go as low as $1,000, but right now, that's my dirty little secret. I mean, I'm open to like $1,350.
$1,350. That's still too high. They'll give you $1,000 cash.
I'm listening. You're getting really close. When someone's this close, they usually just need a little push to put them over the edge. Dead ass, huh?
It does sound good. $1,000. Best I can do.
I'll meet you at 11.
No, can't do it.
How about 1,050?
1,050? We can do that.
You're a hard sell, man.
1,050.
All right, thanks. We had only made $115, but by selling this old bike, which I already had, now we're $1,165 richer. It's not a retirement fund, but hey, I'm glad that Nina put her foot down and demanded that we go to Dickering Days. Looks like I taught my daughter well. Thanks, man.
Appreciate it.
Meanwhile, the Morin brothers have found an interested and very tall and good-looking, if I do say so myself, buyer for that air conditioner they brought from their garage.
What unit, AC, huh? I've been looking for one of them.
Mrs. Fish has been complaining about the hot kitchen at home. So this AC unit, this will definitely be the answer to one of her prayers. But I know Codfish, he ain't gonna want to go over $500. So if they want more than that, then Mrs. Fish, she's just gonna have to leave the icebox door open.
What you looking to get out of the AC?
I'd like to get $600 out of that.
Six, yeah.
Yeah, it's a pretty good unit. It's a Friedrich, so it's a high-end unit.
Yeah.
Got a few little stove-up things there, but...
Yeah, that's the outside unit, so it probably does have a little bit of lawnmower damage or something like that. This little guy looks meek, but I can tell he's not going to let me beat him up too much.
You take three for it?
No, I'm not going to do that. I do want to be fair, though. There's no doubt about that, so I can do a little better. I'll do $500.
Five, huh?
Yeah. That's fair. Nice even number. It's half a thousand.
I got four cash I'll give you.
400 cash?
Yeah. Save you from loading it back? Yeah, you don't have to
load
it.
That's pretty heavy. That's a pretty heavy item. Oh, boy. That's tough. I think 450. Let's do 450. 450 and I'll help you load it.
How about 425?
Four and a quarter?
Save you from loading it again.
That's going to save me from loading it. And that thing is heavy. I'll do four and a quarter.
All right. Sounds good.
Good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I'm only thanking you because you're going to help him load it. Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, that'll be a good rig job.
That's awesome. We already had a $1,345 profit. Now with this $425 sale, we're at $1,770. Booyah! But the best part of the day is still to come because we're going to get the last laugh on Bruce.
I did buy the block and tackle
for $3.
The one I bought off
me. And then I sold it to you for $5. So I made $2 on that, and then you duped me.
I think I didn't dupe you.
You knew my brother sold you that. I didn't know.
Yeah, but that does it all fair in love and trading, right?
That's right.
So how much you make on that? $2. I sold you for $7.
You did sell to me for $7.
Bought you for $5.
So then, well, guess what? I sold it to your partner, Nate.
No.
For $10, I made $3.
Oh, no.
So we made $5. Bruce, you have been outmatched. We are officially the kings of Dickering Days.
Perfect. All right, Bruce, see ya.
Here's the thing about the great state of Maine. In these parts, we actually all like each other.
Thank you, hon.
You're welcome.
You have a good day.
How you doing?
No gated communities here.
Four-wheeler for sale.
Our community is face-to-face.
How about an even 25?
No, I'm not a dicker.
It's mano-a-mano and person-to-person. That's just the way it's done here. We'll need a cold beer and a ride home.
Yeah, wax a leg.
Our noses are never turned up. Because we're living down east.